Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Getting Junk Done. Today's junk, we're talking advertising for my small business. Now, many of you know that I've been running a small business since early 2018. It's a handyman slash landscaping business, and I've been doing everything I can to get my name out there to slowly build up a client base. So first up, my primary way of getting customers at the moment is Craigslist. Craigslist is a great source to put up a variety of ads for what might seem like an okay cost, but it does add up over time. It used to be free where you could post any ads anytime you want, and they started limiting how many ads from the same IP address. And now if you're posting an ad for a service that you provide as a business, it's $5 an ad. $5 a pop, it adds up very quickly. But I do find that in general, it's working. I get a number of calls, emails, and texts all asking for my services. The next thing that I rely on is the website, gettinjunkdone.com. And it's been very beneficial once I got it up and running to the point where I think it's okay for now. But the weird thing about websites is that it needs constant attention. You need to make sure that it's completely up to date and it doesn't look like it's from the 90s or anything like that. You got to make sure that you have current photographs of your jobs and current contact information, and look at it every so often to weed out any typos. Every piece of advertisement that I have that we'll get into actually has the website listed. So people, if they choose to, could go to that website for more information. It's kind of at the beginning of the relationship between me and a potential customer. It's the face of the company. So you want to make sure that it is up to snuff, that it's not a garbage website that people are going to be turned off. So I'm not totally confident in my web skills, so I did the best I could on my website, and if you guys go check it out, give me any suggestions down below, let me know what you think, but it's a work in progress. So we're seeing an actual uptick in the traffic to that website over the past few weeks, and that's a good sign. Another thing that I do is something that every business most likely should have is business cards, and I just got a bunch from Vistaprint. Vistaprint's very cheap, very inexpensive. Business cards are just one of those things you should have. Keep them on hand. I usually give them at the beginning of a conversation with a customer where I'm doing an estimate. So I show up at their property and they're asking me to look at some things. One of the first things I do is give them a business card and introduce myself professionally in this business card. I'm sure there's people out there with half a dozen of my cards that they might just be throwing out at this point. But it's one of those business staples that you just need. And it's a good way to break the ice. Oh, here's my card. Turns out I use Vistaprint a lot. I also have magnets for the side of the work van. And to be honest with you, this is kind of like a cheapo way to get signage on your van. Just get the biggest magnet you can with whatever text or whatever you want on there, images, whatever. And I'm trying to keep it fairly plain right now. And it's just because of money. It costs a lot of money to get your van all decked out. We'll talk about that soon. But the magnets have been beneficial. There's been times when I showed up to a job to do one thing and the magnets list a few different services and they see that and say, hey, while you're at it, how much would it cost for this? Just based on the van sitting out front of their house. And it also advertises to their neighbors. And anytime I'm out on the road, it's a free advertisement. And it's more than paid for itself once I got a job or so from it. So it's been working out, and I highly recommend some sort of signage on your work vehicle. If it's something that you can't truly afford right now, just get the cheapest magnet you can. One job will pay for it, and it does add a certain level of professionalism. I also do targeted mailings, and this is one of those things where you order a bunch of brochures or postcards or flyers or whatever from a company like Vistaprint, and they show up at your house. Then you got to put together all the stamps and everything like that. I've even gone as far as printed out a business letterhead and typed up a nice letter and then signed each one, put that in an envelope with a brochure or the postcard, just introducing myself to other local small businesses and even neighboring customers to people that I already work with and for. That will hopefully build up my route density in the same area. So I could go to one neighborhood and have three or four jobs one day. It's been targeted. That's the whole point, is to target certain areas. And these mailings seem to be a pretty easy way to do that. But the costs do add up. You have to order the brochures or postcards. You have to get the postage. You have to sit down and address them all, whether you handwrite them or you actually print out address labels using your own printer and scanner. The cost of that ink is going to add up very quickly. So all this isn't just the cost of the brochure or postcards, but it does pay for itself after a while. And if you do this for the same neighborhood for a couple of different services and get your name out there, eventually your business name will start to stick in people's memories. And it's all psychological. When they have a problem or something that needs to be addressed or fixed, you want your business name at the top of the list of people they think of, hopefully the very first one, without having to Google and worry about SEO or anything like that. If you're already on their mind, they're going to call you right away. So these mailings seem to be working pretty well, and I've had a lot of success from them. Another old school way is to actually go door to door. And when I was first getting started, I had almost no capital whatsoever. So I printed up a flyer I made just on my own computer, you know, using Microsoft Word or whatever program I had. And I made a bunch of black and white copies on different color paper. So I might not have had color printer, but I did have colored paper. So you go to Walmart, you get a pack of 500 sheets of a variety of colors. The brighter, the better. But once you get your flyer designed, print that out in black ink on colored paper. So that way you are getting an eye-catching delivery method. And then I just went door to door and I put it on the flag of their mailbox, or I tucked it in their door handle. So you know they're going to get it. And if you canvass a neighborhood more than once, it goes back to what we were just talking about. You put your name or your business name at the top of the list of people they think of. How I do my door-to-door is that I refuse to walk on somebody's grass. I stick to the sidewalks and the driveways or whatever path they have. It shows a level of respect. If a neighbor or the homeowner is there watching you walk up their property, why would they want you on your property if you're already disrespecting their property? So I try to make it a habit, and I'm very cautious of this, of staying off the grass and staying out of the garden beds. You're not there for an estimate. You're trying to introduce yourself. So I stick it on the door and I walk away. I don't knock. I don't try and disturb anyone. The biggest reason is that the times that I have to do this generally are in the late afternoon and early evening. That's prime time for dinner. So I don't want to be knocking on the door of anybody's house where they're eating dinner with their family. It's not my business, and that's an instant turnoff. So I just tuck it in there and I take off and I get out of their way. I know they'll find it eventually. And it's been a very non-intrusive way to get my name out there. One of my favorite ways to advertise was actually getting involved in community events. I made a video a while back about one that I was doing. It was called Wolfstock. It was a benefit for the local animal shelter. And there were a variety of vendors and booths and everything set up. And there were hundreds, if not thousands, of people who walked past my booth. I set up a tent. I had a table. I had flyers and brochures and business cards. I set up out a bunch of my tools, chainsaws, and I had my stump grinder there, and everything was out there, so I looked professional. And I had a professional polo with my business logo on my chest, and everything seemed to go well. I got a lot of jobs out of the two events that I did, and this year coming up, I'm going to do at least those same two events, and hopefully maybe half a dozen more. It does cost money to reserve your spot. The Wolfstock event, I think it was $75, but I made several hundred dollars off of that. And I got a few reoccurring customers that generated even more income down the line. So it worked out very well. And I highly recommend just getting involved in the community and getting out there. One of the best reasons for that is the face-to-face interaction with the business owner and the potential client. I had to practice that. And I was not that great. I've gotten much better and I still have a lot to learn. But that kind of really got me going. I hit the ground running and I was out there. I was talking to people and I was learning how to interact with them in a professional way and trying to anticipate their needs, anticipate their questions, and just be efficient with the conversation so I could interact with the next customer. So there wasn't somebody waiting that eventually gets bored and then goes on to the next booth and hires that landscaper. So I want to be efficient but effective, and there's a fine line between taking up too much time and not taking enough time just to get to the next guy. It's a trick that you got to learn, and the only way to do that is to practice with that face-to-face, and these events are perfect for that. So that's what I've done in this past year or so. Now, there are a number of things that I want to expand and get better and actually perfect. Now, I don't know how well I'm going to perfect anything, but there are people who've done these things before me, and I'm going to learn from their mistakes. So a lot of internet research. Speaking of internet, the next thing I want to really get at is my online presence. I want to get on Yelp and Google Places and the white pages and stuff like that. I do know that I have a presence, but it's not, it could be better. I need to adjust the ads. I need to put more information, and I need to sit down and spend the time to get that going. And Facebook is probably the biggest thing I really need to focus on. If I can get a decent Facebook page with a number of followers, that way I could put that on my advertising as well. It's just one more way for customers to interact with me. I mean, let's face it, not everybody likes Facebook. Not everybody likes Twitter or Instagram. Some people might only use one of those three. Why limit myself from that customer base by not getting involved? So I'm going to try and dip my toes into all the social media that I can that seems to be effective for a business like mine. The biggest problem is, personally, I don't really use Facebook all that much. So I have to get in there and learn how it works first and then get this business thing going. It's going to be tricky. It's going to be a challenge, but I need to really get that online presence going this year. Your online presence actually gives you the ability to post positive reviews. Now, sometimes the customers will go on and take the initiative themselves to post a positive review. Other times you might have to actually just come right out and ask them, and there's nothing wrong with that. Just ask them, hey, is there any way you could jot down a few nice words about my company? Or can you email me a couple of sentences about the good job we did? Anything like that. And then get their permission to take those words and their name, maybe first name, last initial, maybe first name and their location, something like that, and post it on your website or anything else. And that will build instant trust and confidence in future potential clients. They'll see all these positive reviews and know that you're doing a good job, at least based on those reviews. And you made them happy. You probably make them happy too. Another thing I want to do this year is get some more signage and color on the work van. I have an idea of how I want to design it, but I haven't worked out exactly how much it's going to cost. And I haven't had the ability to set aside that money yet. So somewhere down the line, I'm going to get more signage on that van. And I think it'll just add to my level of professionalism. And it'll be more eye-catching. We'll see what happens. One lofty idea I have bouncing around in my head a little bit is a billboard. Now, I do not want to put this face on a billboard. That would probably be a detriment to my business. However, if I could get a billboard with my business logo, a couple of bullet points of things I can do, phone number, website, you get the idea. I think I can get a lot of eyes on that, and it might be an experiment worth trying later this year. Maybe at the height of the lawn care season to kind of get even more customers. We'll see. I'm not sure if it's a good idea or not. I've never had a billboard. What are your guys' thoughts? Is a billboard a good idea? Let me know. Going back to the website, something else I want to add to that is an actual quote form. I got to work out the details, but I want to have a form on there that customers can input certain pieces of information that I would simply ask for in doing an estimate anyway. They can put that in themselves without having to pick up the phone and then get an instant quote and then have the option of me calling them or them calling me or having a visit, whatever. A quote form on the website would do even more to pre-qualify even more customers. So I'm going to try and get that worked out in 2019 as well. Well, guys, that's pretty much it. That's what I've gotten so far out of my mistakes I made in the past and research I've made for the future. If you guys like this video, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Gettin Junk Done. Thanks for watching.